Steve Dotto here, and I am some kind of thrilled that you're joining us today. We've got a terrific demo lined up. We're going to take a look at another of the terrific to-do list managers that's available online. Now, I use Asana, and I've shown you a demo on Asana in the past, which is a terrific team-based task and to-do list manager. And we've looked at other ones like Wunderlist, and we'll continue to look at this class of software for a long time, I imagine. I've got one planned coming up for a new product called Todoist, which I'm very impressed with. But the topic today is a tool called Trello. Now, the thing about task and to-do list managers is most of the ones that I've used in the online world are terrific. They really do work well and allow you to work in a collaborative environment. But each one kind of has their own philosophy, their own flavor. Now, while Asana is kind of Spartan and it's got a very dialogue box-based metaphor, Trello has an entirely different feel. Trello has the look and feel of index cards and cork boards, which I love as a metaphor, because for me, it harkens back to when I used to produce my TV show. I had a business partner, a producer that worked on the show with me that was a longtime veteran TV producer, and he brought this system to us, which we used color index cards, and we lined the entire wall, all the walls of our office, with cork boards, and each color of index card represented something, and we put down each and every detail of our TV show on these index cards. So it was like a team-based to-do list manager, a task manager, because we could all see the cork board at any time because we all worked in a shared office space, and we could go and we could modify things and we could move them and we could all see the results right there. And it was a great visual representation of the project that we were working on. The reason that I like Trello so much is it really works with the same metaphor. You can sign up for free and use it. There are premium features, which I will talk about in a few moments, but the free service is fairly robust and rich. Now, when you sign up for free, you're brought into an area where you create different task boards or different boards that are project-based. Now, I've got a few listed here. It's not really a rich environment as far as this demo is concerned, because I really only use Trello on one main project that I work on, which is I'm part of a team that does publicity for a local theater company. And we use Trello, and you can see our Trello board down here. But regardless if you're using it by yourself or using it with a team, you can create your own boards. And each board then becomes a project of its own. And so this is the demo board that I've just created for us for this particular demo. And if I go into the demo for Trello card that I already created for this board, I've already got what I want to cover in this demo listed out. So I'm using the tool here to keep me on track in this demo. So the talking points that I wanted to talk about are talking about labeling, how we use it in a multi-user environment with members, due dates and notifications, and including attachments, which are all really good things around basically putting together a team to-do list. So let's start with the basic card itself. I created the card, and I'll show you how we create a new card before I go on. Just add a card, and here is more important stuff. And of course, I spelled important wrong because I always make spelling mistakes when I do these demos. And then you just click add a card. Once you've added the card, you've got basically a blank card. It's like you've taken a blank index card out of a package, and you've written more important stuff, but you haven't added any information to it. As soon as you've created the card, and then when you click on it, you can then go in and you can start adding extra content and extra value to that particular card. Now, I've already started this card here, so let's work off of this card to see the different things that we can do. The first thing that we can do is we can add members. Now, I've only got a couple of people signed up for this particular business, but you can see me and Dave are available here. So you can assign different tasks to different individuals. And the more members that you have, of course, here is the more people that will be engaged in that particular project. So each of you is an individual and you can be accessed at all times from the different cards, which is great for assigning responsibilities to other people. You're going to love that feature. This is one that I really like, the ability to label it. This tool, Trello, to me is a tremendously visual tool where you can see, again, like we had with our cork boards, where you can see an entire project outlined before you. And you can do that by changing the different colors of labels and actually changing the label titles, actually adding titles. I made this one important stuff. So you can add different colored labels to everything so you can recognize right away what part of the project that card is reflecting. You can also add checklists, and you can see I have a checklist added here. You just click on the checklist, you create a new checklist and add it, and then you create different bullet points. And as you go through and do each of the bullet points, it checks off what's happening within that particular project. And the one nice thing that Trello does is it actually monitors everybody's activity. So if I close this down right now, and then I take a look at the sidebar, it's going to have all of the different things that I've been doing in Trello listed out. So we've got kind of a narrative of what's been happening. So if I checked off those things, one would think that they were tasks that I had done that were being assigned. And you can see that I've completed different things within Trello here, and it's giving us the activity. So you can go in and you can see what other members or what you've done on the project at any time, which is a great kind of junior project management tool. Whoever owns the account can be going in and seeing who's interacting with the account and what they've done with a quick snapshot by using the sidebar. I like that feature. Again, very visual. The other thing that you can do within the different cards themselves is you can create attachments, which really adds a lot of flexibility. You can add spreadsheets or graphics or word processing documents. You can add them from your computer or shared documents in Google Drive or Dropbox. So there's lots of different ways to incorporate additional information into the project. You can be adding invoices or waybill numbers or waybills themselves and scans. You can add all sorts of different types of data into the project, anything that you basically need in order for the project to move ahead. And at any point as well, you can add different comments into cards of where you are with things. And you can say, we did that, it worked. So that note is then added into the comments so that people can see that the comments are there. And of course, they'll be reflected in the sidebar as well. So you see from this list here that we've got some tremendous control over the type of information and the type of tasks that we're going to share within Trello. And the fact that it's multi-user, the fact that we can have multiple users engaged, means that it's just that much more valuable. It's not just a personal task manager, but it becomes a team task manager. And that's really, for me, where it all begins. And we don't have to be in the same office looking at the same corkboards. It's an online presence, so we can all get to it at any time from our computer. And not only from your computer, but you can also, let's just quickly jump here onto my smartphone, and I'll show you that we can also get access to Trello on our phone. Yes, indeed, we can. So here's my phone set up, and let's go in to there, and I've got Trello open up here. Let's just refresh it. And so there's the project that we're just working on, the Trello project right there. And so the exact same index card that we were just talking about, look at it. It even looks the same. It's got the same color coding. It's got all the same stuff. And it's got, if I go down and if I take a look at the checklists, I have to expand it. It doesn't have it all reflected in the same window because, of course, we're talking on a small computer screen here or a small phone screen. But if I've done that last task, now 100% of this is done. And now all of those tasks in that checklist have been taken care of. So we see we have access to the same sort of information on our smartphone. Bottom line, I think Trello is an outstanding tool. And it's one that if I'd actually seen it before I saw Asana, I think it would be my preferred tool. It'd be one that I'd be doing an awful lot more with because I do really feel comfortable and like this card-based metaphor. As a matter of fact, even just doing this demo right now, I'm going, how much work would it be for me to move everything out of Asana and into Trello? I'll give it some thought. Now, I promised that I would talk to you about the premium services, because Trello as a base free service is incredibly full-featured. Everything that we've done here, you can do for free, which makes me a little bit nervous, actually. I like to see people charging a little bit more for things because I want to make sure that they're around. But they think that they're going to be fine, so that's all good. If you go into your profile, you can see there that you can get Trello Gold, which says support Trello and get extra fun and functionality. So this is the kind of the second tier. So free does everything that we've seen. If we choose Trello Gold, it costs us, if you invite new members, they'll give you extra time for free, or you can spend $5 a month or $45 a year to upgrade. And for that, they give you some nice backgrounds to your images, so I guess you can create a real corkboard environment. You probably can anyways. They add stickers, which you can add to your cards. Oh boy. Here's something useful. You can add 250 megabytes larger attachments. So you could have larger attachments, which might well end up being very useful, especially if you're working on graphics projects or something like that in custom emoji. So, okay, that's all fun. And then they encourage you to share, which is absolutely fine if you like the product. And you know, the nature of using Trello, everybody that you work on projects with, you're going to be proselytizing to because you're going to be asking them to sign up. So you're going to be able to add and help Trello to grow. Now, if this was the only upgrade path, I would be concerned about this product because one thing I always want to see is a business case that tells me that they are going to be around in the future. But fortunately, they also have business class. And if we look at their business class service, it costs a fair bit more, but it's for much larger installations, $500 a year. But it does have some really nice features, such as extra control of the board, the ability to export data out instantly, and this is the most important one, syncing within your Google Apps integration. So if you're using Google Apps as a office tool, then you can link your Google Apps to Trello, and then Trello becomes just another tool in your app area. And I think that that is a way that it will really integrate nicely within a corporate environment. You can also create an observer-only role, which is great, so that you can have people who just see what's happening with a project but can't actually post and make changes to the project. So here we see it starting to kind of grow into a real business tool that organizations and enterprises might be looking at and entrenching it as part of their own corporate process. Bottom line, as far as Trello is concerned, is if you are in the market for a task and to-do list manager and multi-user is important to you, which I think it should be, Trello is well worth a look. It's not the only one by any means that's worth a look. Asana is a tremendous, robust tool, and all of these guys keep adding extra functionality all the time. And as I say, the other one that I think is really hot these days is one called Todoist, which I'm going to be doing a demo on very shortly, but they each have their own flavor. They each have their own feel. So you're going to find one that fits and speaks. It speaks to your organizational soul. That is exactly what you're going to be looking for. I hope you found this video today to be useful. I've thoroughly enjoyed putting it together. And as I say, Trello, I'm really tempted to migrate everything over into Trello. I might just end up just closing the office door and spending the next couple of days moving all of my projects into Trello. It's that good a product. As I say, I hope you found this video to be useful. If you have, please subscribe to our channel. That way you get notification of our videos as soon as we produce them. We produce at least one or two new videos in the productivity space each and every week. And while you're at it, while you're clicking around and doing things, how about giving us a like? We always appreciate the thumbs up in YouTube or the thumbs up on Facebook. It tells the world that we're doing a good job, and everybody likes to be told that they're doing a good job. I'm Steve Dotto. Thanks for spending time with us today.